In this video, let's see how we can make ODE45 more accurate. We noticed two problems that have to do with the default settings of ODE45. First, the plots were not smooth. To make the plot smooth, we'll need to interpolate to a smaller time step. Second, our computed solution was not exactly periodic. We can fix this by reducing the default error tolerance. Here are the two plots from our solution to the Lotka-Volterra equations. First, the x and y curves versus time are not smooth. We can see this more clearly if we zoom in to the figure. To make the plot smooth, we'll need to interpolate in time. We'll see how to do this using ODE45. Second, when we integrate over a few periods of the solution, we can see that the curve of y versus x is not exactly periodic. The solution does not exactly repeat itself after each period. We can see this more clearly by zooming into the figure. In fact, the solution is periodic. We're going to need to improve the accuracy of ODE45. Let's go back to MATLAB and fix these problems. This is our live script for the solving the Lotka-Volterra equations. We want to now clean up the errors that we see in these plots. The first error is that in this figure here, the curves are not smooth. That could be an interpolation error. If we look over in the workspace, we see that xy is 57 by 2, so there's only 57 points being plotted. T is 57 by 1. So 57 points is not enough points here. MATLAB is outputting the solution of ODE45 is outputting only 57 points. We can fix that by changing T-span. So instead of just specifying the first value of T in the last, we can put here the lin space function. And then we can go from 0 to 6 pi, but we can specify how many points we need. So you can put a large number here, but here we had 57. So if we go about a factor of 10 more, that's probably enough points. Okay, the way ODE45 works then is it's still going to solve the differential equation at the same 57 points, but it will do its own interpolation and give you an output at 500 points instead of 57 points. It will give you an output at all the specified values of T-span. So we could do the interpolation ourselves, say using cubic spline, but we can let ODE45 do the interpolation for us. So let's run again. So you see now that the Lotka-Volterra equation solution of xy versus t is quite smooth now. Okay, the second problem was that the solution of y versus x is supposed to be periodic. This solution is periodic. So this curve should repeat itself 3 times. The period is 2 pi. But you see that before it looked a little bit more lacking the proper interpolation. Now it's more smooth, but it's still not exactly repeating itself. We can zoom in a little bit and see what the problem is. And here you see some distinct curves here. So it's not exactly periodic. The problem here is that the accuracy of ODE45, the default accuracy, is just not good enough to see that the function is exactly periodic. So we can change the accuracy. To do that, we need to use the options argument. So let me show you what that looks like. We can set options equal to what's called ODE set. You can look at the help pages for ODE set and adjust the relative tolerance of the solution, which is essentially how many significant digits we want the solution to be accurate to. Here we can choose 10 to the minus 4 because the default is 10 to the minus 3. So we've gone from essentially 3 significant digits to 4 significant digits. That can make the code more accurate. And then in the call for ODE45, we need to add an additional argument here, which is the options, okay, which was set by ODE set here. Okay, we can run again. Now you see that the curve for the Lotka-Volterra equations has been cleaned up and it looks perfectly periodic. As you've seen, sometimes the default settings of ODE45 give you less than perfect results. Sometimes you need to interpolate your solution, and sometimes you need to reduce the default error tolerances. You always need to view your results with a skeptical eye and get used to reading the help pages. I refer to them all the time when I'm coding. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.